In this video, we will cover the TriBall. The TriBall is a key component inside of IronCAD and is used throughout the design process. It is used to position parts, features, faces, animations, almost anything that you can select inside of a 3D scene can be manipulated with the TriBall. Therefore, it's key to understand how the TriBall works to ensure that you get the most out of IronCAD. In this video, we're going to show you how to use the various capabilities of the TriBall to position various types of components. So to begin using the TriBall, first we need to select something. So we'll orbit over here to this part and select it. And with it selected, I press F10 on the keyboard to turn on the TriBall. You'll see that there's various handles available, and each serves a specific purpose. You can also right-click on the inside of the TriBall and show other handles as well. But for this demonstration, we'll just show the main set of handles. The outside handles of the TriBall are used for transitioning. With the handle selected, you can either rotate around the axis or move along it. And you'll see here when we move the handle, a value appears and you can type in an exact value for the measurement. The interior handles are used for alignment, and they're used to align the geometry to whatever point you want in 3D space. When you right-click on one of the handles, you get a lot of different options that are available. For instance, you can right-click on the handle and say, I want to align to a point, or a center point, or maybe a midpoint. Finally, we have the 2D planes. When we select the 2D plane, you can move the object along that 2D plane that's selected. And you'll notice we also get values that appear that you can type in and put precise values into. So let's start by taking a look at the alignment handles. I'm going to right-click on this handle here, and I want to align this shape to another piece of geometry. So I right-click on the handle and I say parallel to axis. Then, with the left mouse button, I can click anywhere in the 3D scene on any geometry, and I'll align to that axis. So I'm going to go over here and click on this surface, and you'll see that the part automatically aligns itself. Now, still using the alignment handles, I'll just go over to this other alignment handle and say I want to be parallel to an edge. So I right-click, I pick parallel to edge in the menu that appears, and click on this edge here. And now the part is aligned correctly. You'll notice that the part has changed orientation. I can also use these alignment handles to reverse a part. So I'll just simply right-click on that handle and say reverse, and now the part is in the correct position. Now say I want to align to the center of one of these holes. Well, I'll adjust the camera so I can see the hole that I want to align to. Then I can right-click on the center of the TriBall and say to center point. And I'll just pick on that curved edge. That'll automatically align that part to the center point. If I click on do, I can show you another way to move this part. If I hold down the shift key and I drag with the left mouse button, I can drag the center of the TriBall to that curved edge and I'll get the same effect. So just like that, with a few mouse clicks, we've positioned the component where we want it to be. So now I'm done with the TriBall, I just press F10 again to turn it off. Now moving on, we need to position the key over here. So first we'll select it and then turn on the TriBall. Now one powerful thing about the TriBall is that I can actually reposition it to change where I'm orienting from. And to do that, all I have to do is press the space key. After I press the space key, you notice that the TriBall changes to a gray color. That means that it's free to be able to move. So now I'll just take the center point of that TriBall and dragging it with the left mouse button, I'll place it on this point here, and I'll use this point for my positioning. With the TriBall in the correct location, I now press the space bar to lock the TriBall back onto the part. Now with the TriBall in the right position, first thing I'm going to do is an alignment command. So I'm going to right-click on this handle here and select perpendicular to face. Now I'll click on this face here, and the key is properly aligned. And now to position the key in the right location, all I have to do is simply take the center of the TriBall and drag it up to the point where I want it to go to. And just like that, the key is in the right location. Now moving on, you'll see that these two pieces here are in very different orientations. But again, with the power of the TriBall, it's really quite simple to make a change. What I'm going to do is turn on the TriBall and again press the space key. And then I'm just going to take the center of the TriBall and drag it to this point here. With it being now in the right location, I press space bar to turn the TriBall back blue, so now I'm positioning the object. And again, I'll use these alignment handles. So it's as simple as just right-clicking on the handle, saying parallel to edge, and picking the edge that you want. So there's the first part of our alignment. As we go ahead, we still have that alignment handle selected. I'm going to select on the other handle and again right-click and then say perpendicular to face. So just like that, the part is aligned correctly. Now, as you can probably tell, positioning it is going to be as simple as dragging the center of the TriBall down to that point there. You see Smart Snap gives us feedback as to where we're snapping to, and it's just that simple. Now we're going to continue on here, and we need to align this gate to these two holes on the design. So the first thing I'm going to do is do a point-to-point move. So I've taken this handle, this alignment handle, and I'm going to say I want it to align between two points. So I right-click, say point-to-point, and I just move the mouse over the center of the hole, and you'll see I get a highlight showing me that I'm going to hit the center. I click the mouse once, and then I click the mouse again, and I've defined the two points, and now we've got the part in the correct orientation. And again, to reverse the shape, we just simply select the handle that we want to reverse around, the axis we want to reverse around, right-click, select reverse, and we're done. Now I need to mate these two pieces together. And again, to do that, I'm going to move the TriBall first. So I just press space to undock the TriBall. And then I'm going to right-click on the center and say go to center point, and I'll just pick on this edge here. And now the TriBall is in the correct location. Press space again, and we'll do the same command, this time moving the part. So again, we right-click on the TriBall and say to center point. And then click the edge, and just like that, we're aligned. So you can see with the TriBall, it really is quite simple for positioning components. Now let's do some more advanced positioning with the TriBall. We'll go to this other file here, TriBall 2. And first I'm going to position this rod into its socket. So the first thing I'm going to do is turn on the TriBall, and I'm going to say to center point. And notice we can even select spherical surfaces. So right now we've just aligned to the center of that point there. Now to continue, we want to align to another axis. So we just select this upward facing axis here and say parallel to axis. We click the curved surface. The TriBall automatically orients the part to that curved surface. We now need to position and align this disc part. So I'm going to select it and then turn on the TriBall. And then I'm going to right click on this alignment handle and say perpendicular to face. So I'll just say perpendicular to face. And now we know that the part's perfectly aligned. And now what we can do is snap to that center point. This time again, we're going to move the center of the TriBall, and holding down the shift key, snap to that curved edge, and we'll automatically align into the center. Now the TriBall is not only good for positioning components, it's also good for positioning features and for creating things such as patterns. To show you this, we're going to go to our tools catalog. We're going to drag and drop in a custom hole, and we're just going to go with the defaults. With the hole selected, we turn on the TriBall, and we're just going to move that hole out 3/4 of an inch. Now that we have the hole in the right place, we want to make some linked copies of it. So with the hole still selected, I press the space bar, and I'm going to move the TriBall back 3/4 of an inch back to the center point. Now the other thing we could have done is simply right-clicked on the center of the TriBall and said go to center point and click the curved face, and we would have the same result. And now with the TriBall in the correct location, so we select the axis, and then we move the mouse inside the TriBall. And then holding down the right mouse button, we start to move our mouse. And you'll see that we start to get the move to occur. And now we've moved it about 46 degrees. When we let go of the mouse, a menu appears. And we can either move, copy, link, or create a radial pattern. What we're going to do is actually create a pattern. And we want to create a pattern of 6 holes at 60 degrees. And once we click OK, you can see that the TriBall has created the pattern for us just like that. So the TriBall is very powerful for both moving parts and features and for creating things such as patterns. And we'll do the same over here now. We'll select this hole, and this time we want to create a rectangular pattern. And to do that, we'll just select the hole, and then remember those 2D planes from before. We'll drag inside of those with the right mouse button. And then when we let go, again, we get the menu that appears. It says move copy link. This time it says create a rectangular pattern. So we select that. We put in the values that we want, and we have our final pattern. Finally, the TriBall also works on moving things such as faces. You'll see here that in this base part, we don't actually have any intelligence. So what we have is a selection of faces. So what I'm going to do is go to the bottom right of the screen, and where it says any, that's my selection criteria option. And I'm going to say faces by auto feature. I click this face, and IronCAD's automatically determined that this could possibly be a feature. Now that it's selected, I want to move it. So again, I turn on the TriBall. So you see the TriBall can be used for moving parts, features, faces. If we were to make this an entire thing into assembly, we could use the TriBall to move the entire assembly. The TriBall is used everywhere inside of IronCAD. With the faces selected, again, just like we did before, select the axis you want to move along, begin the move with the mouse button, then put in the precise value that you'd like, click OK, and you're done. So I hope this video has been helpful in letting you understand the power of the TriBall. Again, it's a very important tool inside of IronCAD. Knowing the TriBall ensures that you're going to have success with the product.